So yesterday we created one database with the name commerce and we created one table with the name employee. So continuing with that concept, let me connect with the database. Now, since you have already created the database and you want to reopen it, you want to reconnect with it. So you directly will give the command connect database name, right? We get connected to database successfully. We created this table yesterday. Select asterisk from employee, right? This was the table that we created yesterday. So I have displayed the table in front of you. We were doing between command. Between command, I told you when we want to display the record that satisfies the given range, right? Means select star from employee where e salary between 50,000 and 60,000. So there is one employee which is having the salary coming in the range 50,000 to 60,000, and both the values are included. Both the values are inclusive. Am I clear, 12th class, up till here? Yes, Manreet, Shailza, Gaurav, is the concept clear to all of you? Now, the next command which we are going to study is, the command is like command. Like command is basically used for pattern matching, right? It is basically used for pattern matching. Like suppose I want to display the record of all those employees whose name starts with A. Now here the pattern matching is name should start with A, but it can follow by any number of characters, right? It may have 4 characters, it may have 5 characters, it may have 10 characters, but the condition is it should start with A followed by any number of characters. When you are to match a string where any number of characters can be taken, that time we will use the wildcard percentage symbol. Select star from employee where ename like starting with A followed by any number of characters. This we have denoted with percentage symbol. Percentage symbol here act as a wild card that signifies match any number of characters. Match any number of characters. Okay, so see here, 2 employees are displayed whose name starts with A. Clear? Am I clear with the like command? All of you? Then suppose you want to find exact number of characters, like display the record of those employees whose name should start with D followed by exact 4 characters. Employee name should start with the letter D and followed by exactly 4 characters. Now here you have exact pattern matching, right? So here we will not use percentage wildcard, we'll be using underscore. select star from employee where e name like start with D. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. See, employee Dhruv record has been printed because employee Dhruv, the name starts with D and followed by exactly 4 characters. 1 underscore represents 1 character. Okay. So percentage wildcard represents any number of character matching. Underscore wildcard matches at least 1 character. Okay. So this was about the like command. Now let us proceed to the sorting part. Sorting in general sense means the arrangement of records in ascending or descending order. Right? The default order is ascending, but you can sort your records in descending order also by applying the keyword DESC. Now, if you want to have the sorting of records in MySQL, the clause is order by. With the help of order by command, you can sort your records in any particular order as per your convenience. Select star from employee. Now, order by command is dependent on any field. Whether you want to arrange in ascending order, whether you want to arrange in descending order, the ordering is dependent on any particular column. So as per this table, I am arranging the records in descending order on the basis of salary. Right? So what the command will be? Select star from employee, order by, write the field name on basis of which you want to set the ordering, and write the keyword for descending, DESC. If you will not write DESC, by default, it will display the records in ascending order. Means the employee having the minimum salary will be the first one to be displayed. Right? And if you want in descending order, then you have to write the keyword DESC. Clear? So on the basis of any field, you can set the sorting order. Check it out. The highest salary is 95,000. The highest salary is 95,000. Okay? Then followed by 85. At the last, we have the minimum salary, that is 50,000. So the ordering done on the basis of salary. You can sort on the basis of ename also. Alphabetically wise, it will be arranged. Alphabetically wise. See here. Dhruv. Then Dheeraj. Now see carefully. Dhruv and Dheeraj. First two letters are same. So database check for the third letter. DH Dhruv, DH Dheeraj. Then the database go for the third character. In Dhruv, the third character is R. Then in Dheeraj, third character is E. Have you understood the concept of sorting on the basis of string? Yes. Hiya, Daman, Akriti, concept is clear. Bhavneet, Udit, Anshita, Sukhmani, Sanminder, Ruchika, concept is clear. Ruchika, All right. Similarly, we can have the sorting in ascending order E city. Now for ascending order, you have two options. Either you just write the field name, do not write any keyword. So default ordering is ascending. But still, if you want to explicitly represent the ascending order, the keyword is ASC. Otherwise, aap nahi bhi likhoge, to by default wo ascending nahi karega. But still, if you want to set the ordering, so you can write the keyword ASC, right? Now check the city, see the city column. See the city column carefully. In ascending order, the records have been arranged. Compare this table with the previous table. You will get to know the change. Clear? Now, the next command is AND, logical AND. I told you yesterday about logical OR, that both the conditions should be true. Sorry, either of the conditions should be true. Either both, either any one, if true, the result is true. But in the logical AND, if you want to have the result true, both the conditions must be true. If either of the condition is false, the result is false. Select E code, comma E name, comma E salary from employee, where E code equal to 1005. And E department should be equal to sales. Now see the condition here. You are required to print the E code, name and salary of an employee whose E code should be 1005 and department should be sales. अब यहां पे दो काम है. One, E code should be 1005. Secondly, the department should be sales. The department should be sales. So both the conditions should be true if the result is to be true. Our result is true because our both conditions are true. So the record has been displayed in front of you. Dheeraj employee is having the E code 1005 and he is having department sales. Clear? Is it totally clear, all of you? Any doubt? Yes, 12th class, any doubt? All right. Next comes your update command. Now, what is update? Update means you want to make modifications in the existing record. You want to make modifications in the existing record. Right? Now, updation can be done either without condition, either on the basis of some criteria. Right? If you are doing updation without any condition, it will be applied to all the rows, all the records. But if you are applying the update using some criteria, using some condition, it will be applied to the selected records. Right? So first of all, I show you the journal updation without any condition. So what I want to increase the salary of all employees by rupees 500. To increase the salary of all employees by rupees 500. So command should be update table name, set keyword, whichever field you want to modify, write that field. How much you want to add? 500. Right? In each employee salary, make an increment of 500, and whatever value comes, reassign to the same field. E salary mein 500 add karke dubara E salary mein hi reassign kar diya, and salary get update. Semicolon. Okay, now if you want to see the change, whether the record has been updated or not, select star from employee. Select star from employee. Check it out. Check it out. Compare with the previous table. 500 is added to everybody's salary because I have not put any condition while updation. Am I clear? Yes, 12th class. Am I clear up till here to all of you? Any doubt to any child? Now we shall be doing updation on the basis of some condition, right? Like for example, update the city of employee having E code 1004 from Jabalpur to Delhi. Ek employee hai jiska E code 1004 hai, and we want to change the city from Jabalpur to Delhi. Right? Update employee, set E city equal to Delhi, where E code equal to 1004. The employee having E code 1004 change his city from Jabalpur to Delhi. Earlier the value was Jabalpur, now update with the value Delhi. One row change. If you want to see the change, right now see the table which is in front of you. Dhruv table, Dhruv employee ke record ko dekho, uski city Jabalpur show ho rahi hai, right? Now see, now check. Check the record of Dhruv employee. The city has been updated from Jabalpur to Delhi. How many have noticed? Quickly raise your thumb so that I can also make out how many are attending the lecture. Yes. Okay, Vanshika, please take attendance also and send to me, right? And make sure whose thumb is up and whose thumb is down. Vanshika, am I audible to you? All right. Similarly, you can make other changes like change the department from purchase to finance, right? For the employee Aditya. So update employee, set E department equal to finance, where E name equal to Aditya. Clear? So that was about your update command. Now let us go with some functions, inbuilt functions, some aggregate functions, right? Select sum bracket E salary from employee. Now sum function takes the field as parameter whose value sum you want to calculate, whose values you want to calculate, right? So I want to find the total of all the salaries. So I am taking the sum function. Select sum function, in bracket write the field name from employee semicolon. This is the total salary. Total salary. Clear? Yes, class. Am I clear up till here? Similarly, you can find the average. Select AVG E salary from employee. This will help to find the average of salary, right? 367,500 to be divided by 5. So 73,500 is the average of the salary. Clear? Am I clear, all of you? Next function is maximum. To find maximum value, select max E salary from employee. This function will display the highest salary among the given values. So highest salary is 95,500. Check it out. The highest salary is 95,500. Similarly, min function. Okay. So minimum salary is 50,500. Right. Now see another command. Select count bracket star from employee. Whenever you will write the function count star, count star means to count the total number of records present in the table. Count star means to count the total number of records in the table. Now, as per the table, there are 5 records. So it will display 5. See. Any doubt, any queries to anyone up till here? Yes, 12th class. If you have any doubt, let me know. Then the next command is distinct command. It may happen you may have duplicate values in one column. Like two employees can have same salary. So in the salary field, you may have duplicate column. Clear? So if you want to eliminate the duplicate value and you want to display only one value, you want to eliminate the duplicate values, and duplicate values should be treated as one, right? So for that we use distinct keyword. Distinct keyword will eliminate the distinct value, if any, in the column. Select distinct eSalary from employee. So see, all values are unique. There is no duplicate value. So all the salaries get print. Now let us go with the department. Sales is here. Sales is here. Two times the same value get repeat. Distinct with will eliminate the duplicate value. Select distinct e department from employee. Okay. See here, sales is coming only once. Jabki hamare table mein do employees ka sales department hai, to us database ne kya kiya? Database ne sales department jo multiple time repeat ho raha hai, he has taken it only once. Right? Am I totally clear with the distinct command? Now, when you write simple distinct along with the column name, it will display all the values of that column by eliminating the duplicate values. But when you write the count function along with the distinct function, when you write distinct function, distinct command enclosed inside the count function, now what will happen? E department mein se duplicate values ko hata ke baki values ko uthaya jayega, but outside the command we have count function. So whatever values are there, those will be counted. So the answer will be 4. Check it out. Why not 5? The answer is 4, not 5, because the sales department was repeated, but distinct eliminates the repetition. It eliminates the duplicate value. That is why the result is 4. Now, difference between distinct and count distinct is clear. When you have only distinct command, write values. In both the cases, you have to eliminate duplicate. But in the first case, where count function is not there, only distinct command is there, you just have to write the values of that column by eliminating duplicates. But when you are having distinct associated with the count function, you have to count the total number of records after eliminating the duplicate values. Am I clear to all of you? 12th class up till here, am I clear to everyone in the lecture? Yes, Gaurav, Shailza, Manreet. Any doubt? All right.